We're back on metal. Kai and Tai's Funaki is excited, ready for battle. He's going to have his hands full with a 300-plus pounder.
His opponent, weighing 304 pounds, Mideon.
So as we're set for in-ring competition, Tom, we just took a look moments ago at the path of destruction set forth by the Dudleys. And Bubba Ray and Devon have never been wound too tightly. But when they first came to the World Wrestling Federation, I expected them to be humorous. They were funny. We laughed with them. Nobody's laughing anymore.
I think Bubba Ray and Devon both want to make a statement in the tag team division here in the World Wrestling Federation that they're not funny. They're not just some comedic tag team coming in to for everybody's enjoyment to laugh at. Bubba Ray is a very serious man now. He's got that look in his eye, and especially after they put Terry through a table, you've got to believe they're even more dangerous than ever.
Well, I mean, and again, the danger level escalates far beyond. It's not about wins and losses for the Dudley boys. It's about leaving people laying, and that's a very dangerous proposition.
Anytime the Dudleys come to ringside, you can expect to see some kind of table, some kind of path of destruction, whether it's with the Hardy Boys, Edge, or Christian. I mean, we saw what happened to Christian and Edge just a couple weeks ago as well, and we saw the split lip that Edge received along with a couple loose teeth.
Oh, man. Funaki with a nice cross body. Not able to hold Mideon down for the cover, though. Mideon really on the receiving end so far.
Oh.
Funaki tries to quicken the pace, but runs into a right hand. We saw the Dudley boys Monday on Raw, Tom, in response to Edge and Christian getting involved in their rivalry with the Hardy Boys. The Dudleys went to the Acolyte Protection Agency, as Farouk and Bradshaw have now set up shop, I guess you could say, as guns for hire.
Well, anybody who needs any protection or any problems here in the WWF, it looks like the Acolytes will or can be hired for a price.
So you're saying, like, you know, if I've got a problem, say, with you, for example, I could go to Farouk and Bradshaw, put my cash down on the table, and they take care of me.
Well, if you got enough, because Farouk and Bradshaw are pretty tight with me, pal.
Well, of course, you know, we know that Farouk and Bradshaw, they're always, you know, anytime you can cover a bar tab or make sure they got money for their card games, I guess that's what they're looking for here. Plus, I don't think the Acolytes have minded being in the beating people up business.
And I don't think they're going to discriminate who they beat up here in the World Wrestling Federation. If you got the cash, they got the time.
Of course, we also saw the Mean Street Posse try to do some business with the Acolyte Protection Agency as well. And I have a feeling that there are going to be a lot of people lining up at the door of the APA. Funaki slugging away on the midsection of Mideon. And, of course, Tom, we saw Taz, Kurt Angle, and The Rock's lives all intertwined. First on Raw Monday, where the Great One challenged the Olympic gold medalist in Kurt Angle's hometown of Pittsburgh.
And we saw Kurt Angle's winning streak officially come to an end, and we saw Taz accidentally clothesline The Rock at the end of that match.
And that, of course, led to Thursday on SmackDown, a triple threat match. Taz, The Rock, and Kurt Angle. And when all was said and done in this one, The Rock had things well in hand. The Big Show's involvement, though, allowed Kurt Angle to defeat Taz. But also, Kurt Angle now says he not only beat Taz, but he beat The Rock as well. Well, we also know that The Big Show not only got involved in costing The Rock that victory, but that emphatic choke slam on the floor, Tom, I think tells a story as we head towards No Way Out.
And obviously the Big Show is going to take any advantage he can when it comes to The Rock heading towards No Way Out.
The Rock wasn't done on that evening as Mideon poised on the second rope. Nobody home, though. The Big Show battled Rikishi in a special challenge match, and the Great One got involved with that one as well and actually delivered the Rock bottom on the 500 plus pound Big Show. So you know that when the Big Show and the Rock tangle at No Way Out, the WWF championship opportunity at WrestleMania 2000 is going to be on the line, plus a personal rivalry that's escalating as we go by week after week. Modified move there from Funaki, cover, lateral press, and referee Mike Sparks gets the 2.5. Mideon looks a little surprised by everything that's happening in there.
It looked like he got more on Funaki than it did Mideon. This one, watch this!
Oh, man! No mistake in that one. This one is over. A big win for Mideon here on metal. Don't forget, folks, the Godfather and D'Lo Brown against the Headbangers a little later on, plus a major announcement this past Thursday.